I love altering bottles, doing decoupage, working on it, but it's been long since I did something like that, and I thought, why not to try my hands on decoupage on glass bottle? I have not done it yet, and I thought that would be interesting. And one thing, I don't drink, but yes, many of my friends they drink, and one of the friend was kind enough to share one of the bottle with us, so here I am. So to start with, I'm going to use my artistic gesso for my base, and I am going to use my sponge dauber to have my gesso on all over the bottle. Now I'll start with my gesso work, and I need to just make sure that I cover the complete jar with this gesso. So I'm going to start with one of the edges. Now the reason why I don't wanted to use acrylic paint is because acrylic paints, they tend to come out, and in that case gesso works perfectly. So I thought I will just have a layer of gesso on my project, and I think that will be good to go with my decoupage work. Now here I'm using my sponge dauber. I love this. If you are a follower of my YouTube channel, you must be knowing that how much I love my sponge daubers, and that's the reason I most of the times use this if I have to color my bottle or a big base, because it makes your work very, very, very fast, and it's easy to blend in the colors also and spread your color evenly. I'm done with my first coat, but I can still see some patches, so I'm going to have my second layer of color. Now I am not going to color on the top lid this portion till the end, because I want to hold this bottle and just twist it around more comfortably, and that's the reason I'm going to add my color to the cap and the neck at the last. So don't worry, I am going to do that, but it's just that I'm going to do it at the last. So right now I'm just going to give my second coat of gesso on my glass bottle, and I'm going to make sure that there are no patches or any uneven coloring here and there, so that my bottle looks good. Okay, so by now my bottle has dried out completely and is just looking fab. Like, I can leave it like this only. But yes, once you see my decoupage tissue, you will say, no, I have to complete this and I want to complete it. So now I'm going to have this pretty girl on my bottle. So what I'm going to do is I am going to cut this girl with my water and my paintbrush. And you know the step, right? My trimming work, and I just need to peel off the plies, and my edges are still a little wet. That's the reason I need to be really careful, because obviously I don't want to damage this such a beautiful design. So I'm going to do this very slowly. So okay, now with the same image I have done one more project. Yes, it's already live on my YouTube channel, do check that. And I did a tote bag, a canvas tote bag with this pretty girl, and trust me, my daughter loves that bag. She loves like hanging it around. She doesn't use it because she's not a bag person, but she still loves having it all around. So here my page looks good. So I am just going to give it a good press. Now this I've learned recently with my experience only, that before sticking your paper, make sure you press them well. Otherwise what happens is when these corners, the one which you have trimmed, they tend to have the edgy part, like the corners, which looks like a little wrinkle at times. Now just to avoid that, keep your decoupage tissues on the surface where you are going to stick it, not the exact areas, but on the surface or any of the plain surfaces, and just give it a good press. So what happens is, can you see this has merged really well, and here can you see it's coming out. So just to remove this, give it a good gentle press so that it gets smooth, and when you are working with your paper it will be easier. Now once I'm done with this pressing work, I will just take it out and you just need to make sure that when you are doing your this pressing work, your base is completely dry, otherwise it will get stick to your base. And now it's time to start working with the Mod Podge. So here is my matte finish Mod Podge, and here is my paintbrush. And now I'm going to stick this. So now I know that here I want my image. So what I'm going to do is, I am going to just keep it here, just see where exactly I need it, and now I'll start applying my Mod Podge. Now you need to be really careful when you are applying your Mod Podge, because the more area you cover as per your tissues, that's really good, so that you don't miss out on any of the corners of your tissues where you don't get the proper sticking part. So just be careful whenever you're doing this. Otherwise it's absolutely fine. Decoupage is not a that difficult technique. It's such a fun technique, and just a bit more of adhesive, and now I'm going to stick my pretty curl. Okay, and this looks good. And now with the same brush, I'm just giving it a very, very, very light press. And I'm just going to make sure that I run my brush on the complete area so that I don't leave any of the spaces and I don't have wrinkles later on. And yay, I could do this. Now I need to add some more Mod Podge here, so I will be applying a coat. And now I'm going to press this, and like I always say, that you need to be really, really careful when you are doing this step, because obviously you don't want to miss out any of the areas. And this is just looking fab. Now I can see some wrinkle and paper fold here, and I'm just taking my paper up, adding some Mod Podge, and I'm going to press this. And with this, my decoupage bottle is ready. And now with a clean sponge dauber, I'm just going to give a bit of dabbing so that it dries out well and there is no wrinkle, there is no lines here and there. And this is done, and it's looking such cute and so beautiful. Now I'll let it dry and then I'll be back. Off camera, I realized that I need to add one more layer of gesso or my white paint. This is absolutely not optional, but I just wanted to add. So again, I'm going to add my gesso one layer, but this time I need to be really careful because my image is already up there. So I need to be a little careful, but then yes, this is super easy. You really don't have to take too much of tension out there. And I'm just giving a good press, and I'm going to have this. This is just to avoid any other background color. So I could see some of the yellow patches here, and I really don't know why. Even after two coats of gesso, it was showing, but yes, with the third layer, it is definitely going to go. Now it's time to have the final coat, and that's the coat of Mod Podge, which I always do to my products. And now for this, I am going to also use my glitter. So what I'm going to do is I am just going to have some of the glitter on my table. Now this is a bit of messy thing, but then that's okay, your project looks good, so you should try this. And now with my Mod Podge, I I'm going to have my glitters too. So what I'm going to do is I will have my coat of Mod Podge here, just a tinge of glitter here and there, and this is just to make your project a little more shiny. You just need to dab your Mod Podge, have some glitter, sprinkle it around, just sprinkle it, and this is going to work well. Apply gesso on my top layer, and it's high time that I do that before doing my Mod Podge on the top area. So with my paintbrush, I am going to have a good 2-3 coats of gesso here. I'm done with my gesso, and it's time to have my Mod Podge, the final seal, on the top also. And yes, how can I forget my glitter with that, because it is actually acting like a cherry on the top, because my bottle is just looking amazing in person. I wish I could show you all that how exactly it looks now, but I will be sharing picture and my blog link there. You can see all the fine images of these bottle. I will definitely do that. And with this, my project is done. I am just doing a bit of touch up here and there, and it's ready. So I hope you all enjoyed this tutorial, and if you have any queries, please do comment below. I'll be more than happy to help you guys, and thank you so much for watching. Take care. Bye bye.